Hey everybody, I brought a new car, a Skoda Octavia. It's a really nice car. The only problem, it has no trailer hitch. So in this video I will show you how you can add a trailer hitch to your car by yourself. In a workshop, the installation of a trailer hitch would have cost me around 1300 euros. This aftermarket set with the trailer hitch, the electronic kit had cost me around 370 euros. The brand of this set is Westfalia. After the trailer hitch is installed, I have to go to a workshop again and let them program the control unit of the trailer hitch. This cost me additionally 33 euros, which means that in total this self-assembly kit cost me around 400 euros. In contrast to the workshop, I saved 900 euros. In the first step, I have to clean out the trunk. Later, I will run the cables from the trunk to the fuse box. For this reason, I must remove all the covers under which the cables will be laid later. For the covers in the trunk, you need mostly a Torx 20, Torx 25 and a Torx 45 for the middle cover. To remove the rear bumper, I have to disassemble the rear light. The rear light are held in place with two Torx screws and two pins. The pins are pressed into some rubber bushings. You simply have to pull the taillight out. And here you can see I broke the lower pin. And I broke the lower pin on both sides. I'm not sure why, but I think it was a little construction fail. Later I just super glued the lower pin back on the taillight and it works perfectly fine when I assemble the taillights. I continued by removing the tires. In the next step, I have to remove the inner cover of the fender. I had some difficulties because the inner fender was completely covered in a thick layer of dirt and I had to search for all the screws. To take off the bumper, it's better to have someone with you. After all the screws are unscrewed, the bumper hangs on the two clips by the taillights and in the fender. If you have PDC, you have to disconnect the cable as well. And here you can see my brother holding the bumper by himself because I have to take the package from the nice man from DHL. My brother is holding the bumper and I unplug the plugs from the PDC sensors. Under the plastic bumper you can see the metal bumper. After you have installed the trailer hinge, the old metal bumper is waste. The metal bumper is held in place with 7 Torx screws. In older versions, this can also be hexagonal. In addition to the screws, the metal bumper is held in place with a hook. To dismantle the bumper, you have to pull it upwards. This is a little bit difficult because a sealing compound is smeared around the bumper. Since the old bumper is no longer needed, you can apply some force here. The old screws are simply screwed back in the old threads. To protect the surface from rust, I sprayed some protective spray on the surface. The spray I used to prevent the area from rusting is called in German Unterbodenschutz. I'm not sure how to translate it. Under body protection, something like that. The factory have already provided the body of the car with some holes for a trailer hitch. The holes are hidden under a thick layer of underbody protection. You can simply search for some soft spots and then poke with a screwdriver in the holes. Before you mount the carrier of the trailer hinge, read the instruction carefully. Often these aftermarket kits are made for different models. In my case, you can mount the carrier in two ways. The first position I chose was wrong. I later noticed this and had to mount the carrier again. The screws are tightened with a torque of 60 Newton meters plus 90 degrees. In order to pass the cable from the trunk to the trailer hitch, I need to install a new rubber gummit. The new rubber gummit has a hole where I can pass the cable through, and it also seals the cable against water. Depending on which electronic set you bought, the block for the connection to the trailer hitch is already prepared. or you have to plug in the pins by yourself, and that's in my case. To use the trailer hitch, the bumper needs a cutout. To do this, you need a jigsaw, a cordless drill, a file and some sandpaper. The outlines of the cutout are already drawn on the bumper. The bumper is very unwieldy, so just like the removing at the mounting of the bumper, you need someone with you. All the stuff I had removed from the car to mount the new trailer hitch has to assemble back to the car in reversed order. Now the mechanical part of this build is completed, I start to lay the cable in the trunk and zip tie the new cables to the old cables. The control unit of the trailer hitch is simply glued to the body of the car with double-sided tape. In this shot you can also see where the trailer hitch gets grounded. Now the wiring in the trunk is ready. You can start to run the cable from the trunk to the fuse box. Every 3 centimeters, I zip tie the new cables to the existing cables. Now we are going to connect the control unit of the trailer hitch to the CAN bus. To do this, it's really important that the battery is disconnected. Again, it's very important to read the instruction carefully. Depending on the vehicle and the model, this dip is very different. In my case, I have to disconnect the plug A and C. And this was one of the most annoying steps, because the cable of the plug A is super short and you have to connect the two wires, orange brown and orange green, to the CAN bus of this plug. For this purpose, such cable clamps are added to the set. These have to be put around both cables and then pressed together with a pair of pliers. It works, but I don't find this solution very nice. In other sets, you have to change the pin of the plug A or C. I'm not sure which one it was, but this is a much nicer solution. I don't have much footage from plug A because it took me really long time because the step was really annoying and I forgot to record. Here you can see the plug C where I have to connect the third wire. You can also see how I use the clamps. You have to put the cable clamp about both cables you want to connect and then press the clamp with the pair of pliers together. Next, the fuse for the trailer hitch has to be plugged in the fuse box. This step was plug and play and in contrast to the CAN bus connection quite simple. After I have connected all the cables and plugs, I connected the battery and was able to test if everything works. And that's it. Now I have to put everything back together. On the next day I went to a workshop and they programmed my control unit and also tested if all the lights on the trailer works. And everything works fine. As a resume, I can say I needed 2 days for the self-assembly kit, and you need the time because sometimes it's very difficult to remove all the covers, and the electronic part was also very difficult, and it's sometimes really hard to understand the instructions, but in the end everything works fine. I saved 900 euros. And if you have some experience in working with cars, I would recommend it to do it yourself.